Hello everyone, welcome to Hello Grace. In this video, we are going to learn about build data table activity in UiPath. Go to activity panel and search data table in the activity search bar. There are a couple of data table activities available under data table activities that you can see it here. Let's go one by one. In this video, let's see about build data table activity. Drag and drop build data table activity into workflow designer panel. The purpose of build data table is to store and manipulate the data. Let's see how we are going to use this activity. Click on data table button here. It will open build data table window. Look at here. There are a couple of default names and values are available in the build data table window. Assume that you have a scenario that you have extracted weather information based on your locations on every day and storing into a table. In that case, we can use build data table. We are not going to develop an entire project that extracting weather information and storing into a data table. Just we are going to understand how to build this table. Okay, you can see the default column name as column 1 and column 2, which you can edit based on your required title. Let me edit first column name as YouTube, and this column only support strings. Okay, next you can see the data types drop down option. Here you have to select your data types based on your input. For example, if I want to store the text into this YouTube column, I need to select data type as a string. Okay? Or if I want to store number in this YouTube column, I need to select data type as int32, which means integer. Okay? In our case, I will select data type as string. Next is allow null checkbox. If this checkbox is selected, you can store null values into this column rows. Next is auto increment. This check will be displayed if you select integer data type. If you selected integer as a data type, the value of this column is automatically incremented by 1 every time a new record is added. Then default value field. You can provide a default value if any. For example, if there is a new value to be added in this column while you're doing the transaction, the default value will be appear always if you left it as a blank. Other important option is unique. If you selected this, you can store only unique values in this column. Right, and the next is max length. Here you have to provide the maximum number of characters accepted for this column. If you are not wish to provide any length of the characters, the column accept the maximum length of the characters. For that, the default value is -1. Now we are done. Click on OK. Then I will add the second column name as with URL, and I will add the same input as we did for YouTube column. OK. Now click on OK. Here you can see the default two rows. You can edit the first row, but you cannot edit the second row. I will add manually two rows of data. Make sure that in real time there will be a different scenarios to add your data. I will add the input as YouTube name as Locris and web URL as www.locris.com. And add one more row. then click OK. Now we stored the data, and what is next? Creating an output variable, you can bring out all your stored data. I will create a variable, press Ctrl K and add the name as dt_table and hit enter. Now all your data will be stored in this data table variable. Let's see one small output check. Drag and drop a right line activity or message box activity to display the result. I will drag and drop message box activity here. Call the variable dt_table dot rows of zero again dot toString. This means you are taking the first row and bringing the value of row of 0 and column of 0 from the data table. Let's run this to see the output. Look at here, it's displaying the first column of row value of 0. If you want to understand rows and columns or arrays, please check out my previous videos, and also I will provide the link below in the description. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe and support. Connect with us for more tutorials.